Welcome back, guys. It's Jason with your Hopium-free crypto update. Now, this video is going to be a little unorthodox. It might not be something that you're used to seeing on YouTube, but I think it's pretty important, especially when we look like we're going into a new section of the cryptocurrency bull market. Plenty of life-changing money to be made and, of course, lost. And so, as I mentioned, it seems like it might be unorthodox. I want to prepare myself mentally, emotionally, and of course physically, but primarily mentally and emotionally. And I just wanted to share with you one way that I go about doing that with the market. And that way is reviewing what I've seen in the past. However, I also want to play out what has gone on day by day. Now I can bring up a chart and have a look at it and see, oh, well, this was a huge move up and we've just done that again. And I expect the same thing to happen again. It's very, very easy. But from my experience, and I've been trading for 11 years in property market for 15 years, or started around 15 years ago, and you can use this in any other form in your life. Maybe you've trained for some sporting event or some music recital or anything that you've trained for. You know you've gone back and practiced and practiced and practiced and looked at the competitors, looked at what's going on, the season, the weather outside perhaps, and seeing how all of this has played out. Some of you might think this is completely wishy-washy, you're thinking about it too much, etc. I totally get that, but I'm just sharing with you what I've done and what works for me. And so I reflect often on 2017 and how it looks, and you probably see it as well when it comes to Twitter or wherever you're looking, Reddit, Discord, people will take screenshots of price action from previous sections of the market and then try to overlay it with what we're currently seeing to show that, look, it's happening exactly the same again. Could this be the same as before? And I don't think it's going to be exactly the same, and I think it's throwing us slight curveballs along the way. But in terms of the patterns, it's stuff that we have seen before, and it's just a matter of us getting familiar with what that looks like and starting to read the story, even though it's been told slightly differently. So this time around, you can see that we've had a high and then a very solid correction of 50 or so percent. And we've had a recovery now with a higher low that's now broken to a new swing top. So we've broken out of this resistance level here of 53,000, we've broken to a new top. In the past, in 2017, we ran up, broke highs, came back under, and then continued to break highs. And we just kept making this simple, clean pattern of higher highs and higher lows. But this time around, we see a higher high on the way up and then a lower high. And now we're seeing higher low. So we're starting to get a compression moving into this next stage. Generally, this is a bullish pattern, especially as we break out and create new highs. But the difference here is that we're not seeing just a steady flow all the way up. So I'm preparing for a potential fast breakout. And from what I've seen in the past with these, sometimes we get a fake out above these levels just to see the market come back in and start to consolidate underneath the previous all-time high. So what that might look like is we head up and then come back on top just to see ourselves fall back under and begin to reaccumulate in these levels. We've seen it before on this market just back in April of this year before we crashed into our major low. And so when I see that, I think, look, if we get into that, then we're going through one of these next stages again, this distribution into accumulation, and then we wait to see what the market tells us. There is a lot of ifs, buts, thens, potentially see what happens, but that's why I'm preparing for what could happen on the upside in multiple different ways, and then I'll prepare in case I see what might happen to the downside. If I see some of these lows getting taken out, then I'll start to think, all right, this show is probably over for this period of time and I need to reassess where we're going from this point. That's a brief look at pattern. So I want to assess the pattern and see if I'm seeing these time and time again. The other thing I want to review is volatility. And it's very hard to understand the emotion and the craziness that happens in a market, especially during these tops, and they may only last for a few weeks. So if I take log off, bring the screen all together, you can see that this was very, very fast from about 5,000, 6,000 all the way to 20,000 and then all the way back down again to 6,000. And if we look at the last stage of the bull market of 2017 in particular, the craziness came from around the 6th of December and the peak was on the 17th. So that's 11 days. If you want to count the next five or so days into the crash low, you've now got yourself a total of 16 days. So just over 2 weeks to go up to the peak from the breakout, then all the way back down. And then the market started to reduce the volatility. A few crashes happened and then the market was off. It was the bear market. The market was over from that point. So I'm preparing and seeing that, well, it could be just 11 days and then another few days after that point to get us back to exactly where we were just 2 weeks ago. We've seen stuff like this already. And if we just want to focus particularly on the news or the FUD, like we saw just 2 weeks ago, when we look at September, we had in early September, 1 month ago, we had the liquidation crisis. The leverage longs got liquidated all in one day, huge drop. A couple of weeks later, we then see China FUD come out. And within 2 days, the market was crazy. Fast forward 2 weeks and we're already back at those prices, wiped out all of the FUD. And now we're back above the old all-time high. So looking at this in terms of life-changing money, there is plenty of life-changing money still to be made, but it's really about setting ourselves up in terms of a plan and understanding what's happened in the past and replaying that so that you can work on the emotion and the mental side of the game. It's very easy to think that you're just going to make all this money, but in order to pull that trigger to sell is another thing. And you would know that. I'm sure many of you have experienced that. I've seen your comments. You've talked to me in Patreon as well. If you're interested, Patreon link is down below. Check out that link. And also on the channel, plenty of free content here looking at crypto exit strategies, investing $1,000, what to do with wallets, all that sort of thing. There is a full playlist to help you get started if you're interested in that. But back to Bitcoin and understanding the mental and the emotional side to it, the plan is one thing. I talk about that a lot. Like I showed you, there are plenty of ways to do that. And I'd like to go through questions in order to fix a plan up rather than just tell you what to do. Telling people what to do, it never works. It is absolutely ridiculous. So make sure you've worked on yourself and you've got something written down. Trading and investing is full of what ifs because no one knows what is on the right hand side of this screen. No one knows if Bitcoin will go to $300,000 this year in October. No one knows that. What we do know is how we're going to react to the market price or the pattern. Should we break through particular price points and then retest or reaccumulate before we break that point again? Or if we break down, that's the only thing that we can do. We can only react to what the market is telling us. And the best way to be able to react to something is to have a look at what's happened in the past and prepare for the up, the down, or the sideways movement. As I mentioned earlier in the video, this is a very unorthodox style of video, but I personally love to hear how other investors are thinking about the market and what they can do to improve their position, especially moving forward in case we go into a massive bull market. I'd rather hear how people are thinking rather than them telling me buy it now, sell it at this point, because I honestly don't know if they are going to get it right. And honestly, new people could get it even better, get a better result than someone who's been around in the market for several years. And so that's why I think it's important not to cut yourself short and just look for an answer, but look to be able to create your own questions so that you can answer those questions yourself. So if that's something that interests you, to be able to ask your own questions and answer them, make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit that like button as well. Plenty of videos here that you can go through after this video. I'll leave a link to them at the end. You just have to click on those. And if you want to learn more about trading and investing in cryptocurrencies, check out the Patreon down below. There are still many places left here, about 45, so check those out. And of course, you can follow us on Twitter or on Instagram as well. Lots of cryptocurrency updates over there. So if you enjoyed that, let me know in the comments down below. Is this something that you go through as well? Do you like to plan it out? Do you like to have a game plan in your mind of what's coming next? Or do you just flip a coin and buy on heads and sell on tails? Let us know in the comments down below. If you're making profits, you're doing better than 99% of people. I'll catch you guys at the next video. Like, subscribe, catch you then. Until next one, have more fun to get more done.